morning. Happy Republic Day. I want to discuss what all are the laws that are governing our India when European entered into our province for commercial purpose till we attained a republic system of constitution. The East India Company, comprised of 13 members, wanted to sell Vardhamans. Therefore, the sovereignty of British issued a letter patent permitting them to trade. That was the first law which was implemented in India. Thereafter, after Battle of Plassey and Buxar, the company was ceded with certain districts near Bihar and West Bengal. Therefore, they want some laws to control, collect the taxes. Therefore, the East India Company was again chartered with powers to implement control orders. Thereafter, they were permitted to issue revenue orders. The collector, name of the collector which is now prevailing, is only to collect the taxes. Our Indian leaders who talks about our independence of sovereignty did not concentrate on this issue. They would have renamed the nomenclature of the collectors as district administrator or district administrative of the DM. They are not concentrating on this issue. It is up to them to decide. Thereafter, when the mutiny took place 1857, the British brought India under the direct ruling of United Kingdom. Therefore, all the laws, the McCullough Committee was formed to introduce so many acts. There were two different parliament in United Kingdom. One is Imperial Parliament, another one was Parliament of England. The laws being passed for the purpose of England administration, the laws or bills are based before England Parliament, wherein the Prime Minister, Chief Secretary would be present there to record as a registrar of High Courts or Civil Courts to record the proceedings of the Parliament. Whenever the laws pertaining to colonial countries like India, Burma, Sri Lanka, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand are to be passed, that is called Imperial Parliament. The respective Chief Secretaries of particular Viceroys are permitted to take participate as a registrar to record the proceedings. This is the way lot of acts were passed. The acts, several acts which were prevailing in India were codified. Indian Contract Act, Indian Evidence Act, Indian Penal Code, Code of Criminal Procedure, Transfer of Property Act. If you go through the earlier acts, you could see that the British people have limited control over the Indian territory, because that act itself says that it is extended to only those particular territories which is under the control of India. If you want to understand, whenever there is a town police station in our districts, if the town police station is there, that means that particular district was under the domain of Britishers. There is no town police station. It shows that there was no direct ruling over that particular district. It may be under the domain of the native rulers. This should also be understood by you all. Thereafter, what had happened when India, when the European countries decided to liberate colonial countries in view of the Atlantic Treaty after the completion of Second World War, the they decided to form constitution or constituent assembly. In India, because there was a proposal to liberate India with Pakistan, there was a constituent assembly all over India and so many persons were elected. Dr. Ambedkar was also elected, but unfortunately thereafter there was a proposal for separation of Pakistan and Hindustan. Then that resulted the evaporation of the post of Dr. Ambedkar. Then the another constituent assembly was formed to frame our constitution. Then our Dr. Ambedkar, who contested from Maharashtra, was defeated. That shocked the entire nation, because without the help of Dr. Ambedkar, constituent assembly may not function properly. For this reason, though other so many veteran law scholars were there in the constituent assembly, because they were indulged in the struggle for freedom, they were not concentrated to acquire the knowledge. But Dr. Ambedkar was voluminous man of prudent, laudable knowledge of so many other countries. Therefore, a person from West Bengal, resigned his post and Dr. Ambedkar was elected. So, for the Constituent Assembly, the president was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and for framing Constitution Committee, Dr. Ambedkar was the chairman of that committee. So, therefore, the constituency was brought in, amended, even before formation of constitution, it was amended several times. Dr. Ambedkar tried to introduce so many proposals for equal and social justice that was defeated by the dominant community people who are large in number in the constituent assembly. Finally, the constitution of our country was accepted and adopted. That was the day of 26th November 1949, which we call as Law Day. That was being implemented by gazette notification. That is today, the 26th January 1949. So with this, I want that you all should be equipped with this basic information of our laws prevailing prior to constitution. And there is a provision in the constitution that two provisions are there to check the post-constitutional or the pre-constitutional, that is Article 13 and 395, wherein the existing laws in constitution prevailing prior to the implementation of constitution was adopted and set in action.